work in X number of days. Whereas we can do the same amount of work in Y number of days. Therefore, the work done by A in one day will be 1 by X. Similarly, work done by B in one day will be 1 by Y. Now, to find out the total work done by A and B combinedly in one day will be 1 by X plus 1 by Y. If we simplify it further, we get X plus Y upon XY. This is the formula for work done by two people in one day. Now, let us find what will be the number of days to complete this work by both A and B together. We know that whole work is equal to number of days required to complete the work multiplied by work done in one day. Hence, the total number of days required to complete the work will be total work upon work done in one day. With the formula before, we know that work done in one day is X plus Y upon XY, and total work we consider to be as 1. Therefore, the number of days required to complete the work will be XY upon X plus Y. It was easy, wasn't it? This formula is going to help you in solving the further questions with other concepts as well. Take a note of this formula for sure. Let us now use this formula in an example. Let us consider that A can complete a certain amount of work in 12 days and B can complete the same amount of work in 15 days. But after 3 days, B joins in to help A complete the work. Now, we are required to find that how many days will be required now to complete the work after B has joined in A after 3 days. Let us begin. Work done by A in 3 days will be, first we find out the work done by A in 1 day, that is 1 by 12. Now, the amount of work done in 3 days will be 1 by 12 into 3, which we get as 1 by 4. Now, the remaining amount of work is remaining amount of work after 3 days. It will be 1, considering the total amount of work as 1, minus 1 by 4. That is 3 by 4. Now, let us calculate the work done by A and B together. It will be, using this formula, 12 into 15 upon 12 plus 15, which gives us 20 by 3. Now we know that the remaining work was only 3 by 4. Therefore, we get the number of days as 3 by 4 into 20 by 3, which gives us the answer 5. Therefore, A and B will be together able to complete the work in 5 days, given that B joins in A to complete the work after 3 days. Let us now understand the concept of work done by 3 people. Let us consider that A does the work in X number of days, B in Y number of days, and C does it in Z number of days. It is very similar to that of 2 people. Now, if A does a certain work in X days, the amount of work done by A in one day will be 1 by X. By B will be 1 by Y. And by C will be 1 by Z. Hence, the work done by all 3 of them combined in one day will be 1 by X plus 1 by Y plus 1 by Z, which gives us XY plus YZ plus ZX by XYZ. Now, we know that the number of days required to complete a work is equal to the whole work that needs to be done upon amount of work done in one day. Therefore, number of days required here will be 1, considering that the total work to be done is a single unit, upon xy plus yz plus zx upon xyz, which gives us the answer as xyz upon xy plus yz plus zx. Hence, if 3 people work together, they will require these many number of days to complete the work. Let us now consider an example to understand the formula derived before. Let us consider that A can do a certain amount of work in 15 days. B can do the same work in 12 days. Whereas C does the same work in 20 days. Recalling our formula, xyz upon xy plus yz upon xz. Putting these numericals in this formula, we get 15 into 12 into 20 upon 15 into 12 plus 12 into 20 plus 15 into 20. By calculating this, we get 3600 by 720, which gives us the answer as 5 days. Therefore, when A, B and C work together to complete a certain task, they complete it in 5 days.